हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर यूनिट नंबर 3, दैट इज द मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। इन द पार्ट 1 वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स ऑफ करंट। द यूनिट इज द मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड द मैग्नेटिज्म, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द रेफरेंस बुक दिस इज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज द मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स ऑफ करंट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन टुडेज वीडियो। नाउ what is the meaning of the magnetic effects of current? Magnetic effects of current means that whenever a current is flowing through the wire, there is the magnetic field around the wire. Whenever there is the current in the wire, there is the magnetic field around the wire, and this was explained by the Oersted. It is given by the Oersted. And it is known as Oersted's experiment. All of you have studied in class 10 Oersted's experiment. What is the Oersted's experiment? Oersted take a wire. Through this wire, the current was flowing. And then he take a magnetic compass near this current carrying wire. What he saw? He saw that there was a deflection in the magnetic compass, and the deflection shows that there is the magnetic field. There is magnetic field. So, according to Oersted, whenever the current flows through the wire, there is the production of magnetic field around that wire, and this effect is known as the magnetic effect of electric current. Now, let's come to the magnetic field. What is the magnetic field? All of you already have well known about this term. You have studied in class 10. That is the magnetic field. We have a magnet. Let us suppose we have a bar magnet having the north and south pole. Around this magnet, there will be the space. There will be space around this magnet in which the another magnet can experience its influence. The space exists around the magnet in which there exists its influence any another magnet. Outside this boundary, there will be the no effect of this magnet on the another magnet. And this space is called the magnetic field. What is the magnetic field? The space around the magnet in which its influence can be experienced by another magnet is called magnetic field. Now let's come to the magnetic field intensity. What is the magnetic field intensity? Magnetic field intensity is the value of the magnetic field at particular point inside the magnetic field. For example, I have the point P, and in this, so magnetic field intensity is the strength or value of magnetic field at particular point in the magnetic field. Magnetic field intensity, or generally it is named as the magnetic field, and we are going to denote magnetic field with B. Magnetic field is denoted by capital B. Magnetic field is the vector quantity. Okay. Now next come to the most important topic, that is the Biot-Savart's law.
Biot-Savart's law is basically mathematical rule, or you can say the mathematical law that is used to calculate the magnetic field due to any current carrying configuration. Any current carrying conductor, we can calculate the magnetic field with the help of the Biot-Savart's law. Now, let us suppose we have a conductor of length L, and let us suppose current is flowing I. Through this current carrying conductor, current is flowing I, and let us suppose this is the point electrons are from this current carrying conductor. Then the r cap represents the direction of observation point. And let us suppose I am going to consider the elementary length dl, of this conductor, and it is the length factor in the direction of the current. Now, according to Biot-Savitz, the magnitude of the magnetic field, at a point P due to this elementary length dl is given by, first one is the dB, magnetic field, small magnetic field at a point P due to elementary length dl is directly proportional to the current through the conductor. So the first dependence, the magnetic field is directly proportional to the current flowing through the conductor. Next one is the magnetic field is directly proportional to the length element. dB is directly proportional to dl. And third one, magnetic field is directly inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Magnetic field is inversely proportional to the square of the distance of observation point P. Fourth, dB is directly proportional to sine of angle. Sine of angle, which angle? This one angle. The angle between the current element and the direction of the observation point R cap. Or you can say that the position vector of the point P with respect to this current carrying conductor. Now I am going to combine these. So dB is directly proportional to idl sin theta upon r square. Idl sin theta upon r square. So constant of proportionality k idl sin theta upon r square. Here k depends on the medium. K depends upon the medium and the units of the measurement. Now for the medium, if the medium is the vacuum or the air and the system of measurements is the SI system, then K is given by mu naught by 4 pi having the value 10 power minus 7. Having value 10 power minus 7, Tesla, what will be the units? The magnetic field is measured in the Tesla, meter per ampere. That will be the Tesla meter per ampere. So this is the value of the K for the SI system and for the vacuum. So dB will be equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta upon R square. Idl sin theta upon R square. And if you want to calculate a total magnetic field, then you can integrate it. Then the total magnetic field is given by B is integration of dB, or B will be equal to mu naught by 4 pi integration idl sin theta upon R square. Idl sin theta divided by R square. So in this way, you can calculate the magnitude of the magnetic field due to current carrying conductor with the help of the Biot-Savitz law. Now next come to the, if I want to express this magnetic field in the vector form, because we know that magnetic field is the vector quantity, it has the direction. So I want to write this expression in the vector form, this one, dB. Mu naught by 4 pi idl sin theta upon r square. Now I am going to write it as V dB mu naught by 4 pi idl vector mod r cap mod sin theta upon r square. You can write like this. If I multiply the magnitude of the unit vector, I think I didn't make any mistake here.
So dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi idl magnitude r cap sin theta upon r square.
Now you can write it as
dB vector is mu naught by 4 pi idl vector cross r cap upon r square.
IdL
cross r cap upon r square. So this is the expression for the magnetic field in the vector form
that we have calculated by using Biot-Savart's law. Clear? Now next one is the, if you want to calculate the direction of this magnetic field, the direction of the magnetic field can be calculated by using the right hand thumb rule.
The direction of magnetic field is calculated by using right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule, which one? For vector product that we are going to use. For the vector product, I have erased the diagram. I am going to draw it again. The diagram was, once again, we have drawn the diagram like this. This is the conductor, point P at a distance r. Current is flowing in upward direction. This is the direction of r cap and dl vector, idl vector. So this is the angle theta between these. And we have expressed dB vector as mu naught by 4 pi idl cross r cap upon r square. I have written like this. Now we want to calculate the direction of this dB vector. Whenever the cross product is given, we can easily calculate the direction of the resultant quantity. How? By applying the right hand rule for the vector product. What is that rule? Now I am going to curl my fingers in such a direction that the theta is going to hold in my palm of right hand. I want to hold the angle theta in my palm with right hand. Which theta? The smallest angle between the vectors. Now this is also angle here. If you can see this larger angle, jo bade wala angle hai, wo bhi to kiske beech mein ban raha hai, idl aur r cap ke beech mein aa raha hai na. But humne kaun sa angle dekhna hai? That is the smallest angle. We are going to see the smallest angle between the idl and r cap. Now this is the smallest angle theta that I have shown with the bold line. Now I am going to hold this angle in my right hand. I am going to hold this angle in my right hand such that smallest angle, and fingers should curl from first term to the second term. Means fingers should move from idl to r cap. Now idl is this one and r cap is this one, and we are going to hold the smallest angle. So idl, I have placed my fingers here and I am going to hold this theta from r cap. If I am going to do this, you can also do this, okay? Or you can move from here to here. So the thumb is pointing in the direction that is inward. Inward and perpendicular to this plane of the board. So the direction of the dB vector here is perpendicular to plane of board and it is inward in direction. Clear? So in this way you can calculate the direction of the magnetic field by applying the right hand thumb rule for the vector product. Clear? Now next one, we have the
two applications of Biot-Savart's law.
Next is the application of Biot-Savart's law. Application of Biot-Savart's law. In the first case,
we have given a circular loop. We have to calculate a magnetic field at the center of circular loop. Magnetic field at center of circular loop. Let us suppose I have a circular loop like this. I have a circular loop. Let us suppose current I is flowing through it in the clockwise direction. Current I is flowing through this loop in the clockwise direction. Now I want to calculate the magnetic field at the center of the loop. I want to calculate magnetic field at the center of the loop. Let us suppose A is the radius of the loop. Firstly, I will calculate a small magnetic field due to elementary length. Let us suppose AB is the elementary length having the length DL, and the direction of this elementary length DL will be given by the tangent drawn to this circular loop at the point this one C. Elementary length means the length of the AB portion is very short and B points lies very close to each other, or you can say that AB and C points all lies at the same tangent. So this is the direction we have to calculate at the center. So direction of the A cap or the R cap is given in the downward direction. So the angle between the IDL vector and the R cap is the 90 degree. Now according to Biot's law, what is the definition of Biot's law? Small magnetic field dB is given by mu naught by 4 pi IDL cross R cap upon R square. This is the definition that we have written in the previous article. So dB vector is mu naught by 4 pi. If I am going to open the cross product, it will be IDL sine. Angle is 90 degree and instead of A we have the A square. So sine 90 is 1. So dB is mu naught by 4 pi IDL upon A square. This is the small magnetic field at the center of this current carrying loop according to the this elementary length, that is the DL or the AB portion. Now total magnetic field or the net magnetic field is given by the integration u naught by 4 pi to the outside, 1 by a square outside, I outside, and integration over the DL. What will be the integration of the DL? That is the length of this loop, and the length of the loop will be equal to the circumference of the loop. So B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I by A square into 2 pi A goes with A. So from here the B will be equal to mu naught by 4 pi 2 pi I by A. This is the formula to calculate a magnetic field at the center of current carrying loop by using Biot-Savart's law. Now if this loop contains the n number of turns, then the magnetic field will be B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi 2 pi n I upon A. Means magnetic field is going to be n times if this loop has the n number of turns. Now if you want to calculate the direction of the magnetic field at the center of the loop, the direction of the magnetic field can be calculated by applying the right hand thumb rule. Now this is the direction of the IDL A. Now we are going to curl our fingers from IDL A to hold the smallest angle. So I am going to move my fingers like this, from this to this. The thumb is pointing inward and perpendicular to the plane of the board. So in this case the direction of the magnetic field will be perpendicular to plane of board and it will be inward in the direction. Now next we have the rule to calculate the direction of the magnetic field in the loop. That is the NS rule that we will use a number of times in this chapter. You should know about the NS rule. Next is the NS rule. NS rule means if the current flowing through the loop is in the anti-clockwise direction, we have a loop. If the current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction, in that case, it will behave as the non-rule. And if the current is flowing in the clockwise direction, in that case, it will behave as the south pole. If through the one phase of the loop the current is flowing in the anti-clockwise direction, it will behave as the north pole. And if the current is flowing in the clockwise direction, it will behave as the south pole. Now the next is, we are going to find the magnetic field at a point on the axis of this current carrying loop, again with the help of the Biot-Savart's law. Next topic is the magnetic field on axis of current carrying loop. Now let us suppose we have a loop. And current is flowing through this loop is the anti-clockwise direction. The center of the loop is the O, and this is the point P at distance x from the center of the loop. I think it is not going to be nice. I'm going to draw it again. I think it is better. Now, center O, point P at a distance x, and current is flowing in the anti-clockwise direction through this loop. Let us suppose A is the radius of the loop. Now, next one is the, we have to calculate the magnetic field at a point P. Again, I am going to divide this loop into elementary portions. And first elementary portion I am going to consider, that is the AB. First elementary portion, that is AB here. And this is the center point C. Let us suppose this point P is at a distance R from this elementary point. Elementary length. We are going to calculate magnetic field at point P due to this elementary portion AB. To calculate the magnetic field at a point B, we are going to apply the Biot-Savart's law. So dB will be equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta upon R square. Now what is the angle between IDL and R? Now IDL is acting in this direction. This is the direction of the IDL. And this is the observation distance. So you can see that I'm going to draw again from here. This is the observation distance. Clearly, the angle between this line and this will be 90 degrees, because this is the tangent and this is also, you can see that a straight line is cutting at the point C. So angle is the 90 degree. From here, dB is equal to
mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta sin 90 will be 1 upon r square. Name it equation.
Now what about the direction of the dB? We are going to calculate the direction of dB vector here. The direction of the dB vector is given by, the direction of the dB vector we can calculate by applying the right hand rule for the vector product.
Now what is the right hand rule? Now this is the ideal, direction of ideal, and this is the direction of the observation point. Now we are moving from A to, we are moving from A to R, or you can say that ideal to R. In such a direction, we are going to hold the smallest angle in our palm. So, if I am going to do this, the thumb will point like this. Thumb is perpendicular and inward. Like this. Inward means, sorry. Like this. I am going to hold this angle. Outward. Okay. So, this angle, dB. dB vector is representing the direction of the magnetic field at a point B due to this elementary portion, that is AB. Now, dB is making angle theta. dB is making angle theta. If this is angle theta, this angle will be also equal to theta with this dotted line. Now, we can resolve the dB into components. Along this line, there will be dB cos theta. And perpendicular component will be dB sine. Now for the component AB, there is the opposite component or sorry portion, that is the A dash B dash elementary portion. Again, let us know the length of this elementary portion is again dl, and this elementary portion will be at distance r again from this point. This is the C point. Now, again you can find the angle between the IDL and the R cap will be 90 degree. So, dB dash, that will be mu naught by 4 pi IDL upon R scale. But in this case, the direction of IDL will be like this. The direction of the IDL will be like this, or you can see that it is acting along this direction. Or opposite to the initial phase. If the direction of ideal is reversed, then the direction of the magnetic field will also get reversed. So, dB dash is acting in the inward direction and perpendicular to plane. Again, this angle is theta. Resolve into component dB dash cos theta, and on this side, there will be the dB dash sine. Now, dB dash and dB in magnitude are equal. So, the components acting dB dash cos theta and dB dash sin theta along the vertical, equal and opposite, they are going to cancel each other. So, the net magnetic field will be dB dash sin theta plus dB sin theta for the two elementary portions. Now, but we have the circular rule for the each elementary portion, there will be equal and opposite elementary portion existing for the each elementary portion. So, for the each elementary portion, we have a contribution of dB sin theta. And the net magnetic field will be equal to, what will be the value of net magnetic field? That is integration of dB sin theta. Now, we are going to calculate the net magnetic field. So, the net magnetic field B will be integration of dB sin theta. Now, we are talking about this angle theta here. This will be also, this is A. Now, B is equal to integration of dB sin theta. So, put the value of dB, integration mu naught by 4 pi IDL sin theta upon R square. Now we are going to solve it. Now sin theta does not depend on the length. We are going to calculate the integration over the length. So B will be equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl, sorry, I sin theta,
I sin theta upon r square outside
integration dl.
dl is the elementary length of this circular loop.
So b will be equal to mu naught by 4 pi I by r square.
Now we can calculate the value of the sin theta from the triangle COP.
Sin theta will be equal to a upon under root
r square plus a square. We can put the value of the sin theta here. Now we are going to put the value of sin theta.
Sin theta will be a radius upon r. R will be equal to under root a square plus x square. A square plus x square, x square, we are going to write a square plus x square as it is. Then, sorry, here is the sin theta is having the under root. And r square I can also write on the value of a square plus x square into dl, that is the 2 pi a circumference of the circular loop. So, b will be mu naught by 4 pi 2 pi I a upon x square plus a square raised to power 3 pi.
This is the magnetic field. Due to this current carrying circular loop at a point on the axis of this current carrying loop.
Now if P lies at the center, if the P lies at the center of this loop, in that case x will be 0. X is going to be 0 and the answer will be B will be equal to mu naught by 4 pi 2 pi I upon a square, that we have already calculated.
So from this article you can also find the magnetic field at the center of the circular loop.
Now if this loop contains n number of turns, the magnetic field will becomes n.
So this is all about the Biot-Savart's law and its applications. In the next video, we will do about the Ampere's circuitry law. Thank you.